revenge on me for when I beat him. He just 3-0'd my ass. That was not. Oh my god.
Yeah, Smasher's.
He's so good.
He got his revenge on you.
Yeah.
After you got that win on him.
I got the win on him. He got 25th that week. The next week he wins Smash Shield. I'm like, dude, I just motivated you.
That just
shows
you the volatility of this game.
It's crazy. But yeah. We got an expensive match here on the screen. At least 998. Is that the correct math? Yeah, 998.
Yeah. Oh, is that the total?
Total.
Is that with tax, though?
Yeah. Oh, I don't know if that is. Okay.
You know Nintendo's going to be charging that sales tax.
They know how to get every nickel and dime out of you. Hey, here's a good character.
Yeah, man.
And here's Gucci.
I think with tax, it'd be 1058.
Damn.
Oh, man.
That's a lot
of
money.
That's a lot of money.
That's
tax
gets you, dude.
But you know what? You play that character, you win a tournament, you make it right on back. So.
Wow. Daybreak and Ryoku. Just reminding us how far in bracket we actually are here. So, you know, only about 20 entrants, but stacked nonetheless. We have so many, like, we have a lot of, like, PR hopefuls here that are in here.
I mean, Ryoku, Daybreak's already on the PR, but Ryoku with a lot of notable wins this season. I mean, you look around, we just saw Trier Train. Ori's even here, King James. A lot of great players, but here's two of them right now. And Daybreak opting for this Cloud. Can't blame him in this matchup. Supposedly, Bayo loses to Cloud, so.
Yeah, one of the things I like about Daybreak's Cloud the most is his movement. His movement's really good. You see him in the air using his aerials, mixing up the way he's going to come in, and it's just so much fun to watch.
Even, like, a lot of the times, his movement in the air is jump, air dodge, to, like, auto-cancel down air, and like, all of that is so, so safe, and that tomahawk grab was excellent.
Yeah, he plays a really safe Cloud too, and that's something you kind of have to do, and it's going to give you the best chance to win.
Yeah,
it's just optimal. But Ryoku getting him into a banana combo, but not really able to do anything. Great SDI from Daybreak, gonna sneak him out of that afterburner kick.
Match within though, getting a little bit in the way, but Daybreak right now with this limit, very, very intimidating. He's going to have to find that opportunity to use it, find that cross slash. Hopefully he doesn't have to use it for recovery here.
That's something. Oh my gosh. Yeah, just tomahawk.
Like it looked like he almost reacted to a spot dodge and did it. I'm like, that's crazy.
I think that Ryoku was preparing for maybe an up air or maybe a grab. I think he was thinking the grab was going to come out, but he didn't expect a long lasting hitbox that's as powerful as limit cross slash. So that was just a really good read from Daybreak, thinking, okay, I've conditioned you.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what he kind of does, too. Like, you'll see it a lot. Like, he does so many tomahawk grabs.
And a lot of the times, too, as well, is, like, he'll throw those up airs out and hit you with three in a row. And instead of throwing a fourth one out, he just lands and charges limit. And, like, as the mix-up, because this guy's now, like, drifting away at air dodging, gives him time. And he already has limit again with 76% on Ryoku, like, by the ledge.
Yeah, Daybreak's pretty good in this matchup, even.
Yeah, he really is.
He does make it look... not as horrid.
I mean, supposedly Cloud wins, but it's still close. Like, yeah, it's still very difficult.
It's very close. And he's certainly well-versed in that.
Reverse nair to up air, though. Nice little string for Daybreak. Daybreak putting the pressure on that platform. He's just kind of throwing it out there. But honestly, he might die soon, so let's at least put the effort out there. And if you connect, you just win. So not the worst idea.
Yeah. Ryoku just needs to seal this stock off, though. Sitting at 125%, you have already been lapped. Almost. Yeah. Oh, man, that's it.
Ooh, Cloud with Rage. Bayonetta with over 100% up air. Ooh.
Yeah, afterburner kick is one of the most commonly gone to recovery options after you're off ledge.
Mm-hmm.
So Daybreak knew that, and he's just going to up air and intercept, and that's what he did. So pretty smart from Daybreak. He seemed to kind of be one step ahead of Ryoku at every turn.
Yeah, it looked like Ryoku was always playing catch up, sadly.
Yeah. So we'll see if he can make the adjustment back to town and city, which I can understand that. This is a good stage for Bayonetta. Obviously looking to probably take Daybreak off to the top. Take him to the heavens.
Off the top, you hit one witch time, you up smash them, they go off the top again.
Yeah.
So
just a lot of ways to kill.
And oh my god, Ryoku off the start, putting in some really nice damage, carrying Daybreak off the stage. But Daybreak is going to DI and SDI in, which is definitely going to allow him to get back to stage. But it was looking very scary for a moment. Still might be.
Yeah. Oh, he's got to be careful. Yeah, I was just kind of expecting Ryoku to do that. He didn't hold shit long enough. Just got to expect that.
Yeah. Both these players, like, I don't think I've ever seen them play before. I'm really curious how the Falco does against Ryoku. I'm not saying he should go Falco. I think the Cloud's doing fantastic.
I can't imagine that matchup being fun in any way.
It can't be, right? Like, I was just thinking about it. Like,
I don't think there's a chance he'll go Falco. Unless, No, I don't think.
I would say it's like 90% sure Cloud all the way.
I can't. I mean, maybe if he was down 2-0, maybe. Oh, nice. Got the up 61%?
Air. 61%?
Up air to finishing touch confirm.
Oh.
That's basically true.
Yeah, no, it's very good. Oh,
ooh,
wow.
Ryoku wanted the answer right back. Almost got it, too. Good percent nonetheless.
Yeah, no, super good stuff. As well as Daybreak's nowhere close to a limit right now. So all he has to do is hit him with that one witch twist to send him away. All right,
there you go.
Simple stuff.
Yeah.
Nice little taunt. Ryoku kind of feeling himself, hopefully. Let's see if he can carry that momentum.
Well, he doesn't really want to fall down 2-0 here. Not against Daybreak. Against that kind of momentum. And Daybreak on the PR number 10. He's definitely been here before.
As well as, like, Ryoku really wants this win. This would be a great win for Ryoku. Wait, is this PR eligible?
Yeah. Okay. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
20, I think we probably barely broke it.
Heck yeah. So, yeah, this would be a great win for Ryoku. I know. 26? That's not bad. Ryoku off stage right now, though. Definitely doesn't want to be there. Limit charge almost here from Daybreak. Gosh. If he gets him in the situation, oh my goodness, Crosslash is looking scary. Unless he gets another one of those really nice landing up airs to finish the touch.
The aerial pressure from Daybreak is absolutely ridiculous, and that was so smart!
Did he B-reverse that? That was so good.
So. Yeah.
Holy.
And he's just like, you're going to come up and intercept me.
Yeah.
No, you're not.
I'm now, because he was facing the wrong way. Turn around and just instantly took him out.
Well, we're going to catch a replay.
Yeah, I'm
interested. First, notice the pressure on the platform as he like threw out three straight aerials. Finally got him the drop shield.
Yeah, and now here he is. And this situation looks dire, but he just air dodges through, turned around cross slash.
Here's the thing. I mean, once Ryoku afterburnered off stage, he's he's not just going to fall.
No, no.
Yeah, so that was a pretty easy read for Daybreak to make.
Yeah, it was either Ryoku was going to get aggressive or he was going to go to that ledge.
Yeah,
and like
go to ledge too. Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of the times at the ledge, Daybreak, I think, killed him twice there from not hanging on too long, but just covering his options. So he didn't feel comfortable with it. And now he's on 2-0, though. I don't know, man.
Yep, back against the wall. We'll see what's out. But hey, off to a wonderful start here in game number 3. 80% unanswered until then.
Yeah, he's putting a lot of pressure on. He got a little too antsy with that down air, a little too aggressive, but... You know what, when you're feeling yourself and you're putting some nice damage down, sometimes you just throw that down air, hope it hits. And if it does, you even look better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So far, okay.
Great upbeat, my goodness. Daybreak, Cloud is so bad off stage, but he's been getting back left and right.
Yeah, you'd think that Bayonetta would just destroy Cloud off stage, which honestly, yeah, Bayonetta certainly is a monster off stage against Cloud. But like you said, Daybreak just doing a great job of just kind of playing around Ryoku, who really hasn't been too much of a challenge offstage.
Oh man, Ryoku had a chance right there. Daybreak going over the ledge. Almost has his limit now with Max Rage, like on Town and City, up air so scary,
nice.
Holy crap.
Yeah, I feel like Ryoku's a little flustered. He just doesn't really have an answer to get these stocks off of Daybreak. Like he's had such, that's within.
Oh!
Oh my God. How does that happen?
Oh, what the hell?
What kind of exchange was that?
Right. Bats within to end your limit cross slash to spot dodge the F smash to F smash.
I can't believe Daybreak had enough time to react and not get hit by that forward smash. Like that was insane.
Yeah, I don't know. But like that forward smash was actually really, really good from Ryoku. It
was the right idea.
Yeah, it was great.
But how Bats within got him out of that. That was amazing.
Yeah, that was something else. But now Daybreak's. Oh.
I think that's the story of this match.
Yeah, it really was right there.
That's just how things went for Ryoku. And Daybreak's still living at 160.
And, like, this is Max Rage, Bayonetta on Town and City. Like, Max Rage Cloud against Bayonetta. Don't get me wrong, he's dead now. But at 150 with that Rage on Town and City, up air is so, so threatening. But Ryoku not going to have to worry about it right now.
Absolutely not.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's still a good move, but it ain't going to kill him. And here we go. If Ryoku can get this
set
up correctly, that's the stock.
Oh, Daybreak just barely living out there in the blast zone.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no. That's it.
Oh.
No, it's not.
How?
Wait, does he have enough to get back?
Yeah.
I thought they was dead for sure.
I thought so, too. We saw the kill sparks.
Yeah.
Town and City blast zones. I'm like,
I hate when I do that.
I know,
like
right?
Such an idiot.
Yeah, I did it the other day, and I'm like, oh,
wow.
That's okay.
The problem is if Bayonetta doesn't go in the blast zone, then she's alive.
Right.
This could be. Oh, no. All right.
Daybreak always like going up. I like that, honestly. Already holding shield for a little bit. Ryoku might just drop. And then Ryoku giving him some space to get. He's already halfway back. Like.
He is back right now. This is anybody's game. And just a couple witch twist combos later and some offstage pressure, and you've got it. And Daybreak now looking like he's the kind of one desperately looking for this stock.
I mean, he's about to have limit any second now, so, like, not the biggest deal, in which has it right now. So he just throws it.
Wow.
But he actually gets hit, but Ryoku not going to get hit by, like, the strong kill part.
Yeah, he got hit by, like, the outer part of that, and that's going to be it. And, wow, Daybreak was in command, but Ryoku works his way all the way back. And it just looked like Ryoku was so lost.
Yeah, initially, it was very tough for Ryoku because after that F smash, anybody would be flustered, right? That'd be so tough. Keeping enough composure to figure it out, find his way in, and all it took was 3 or 4 combos. And next thing you know, Daybreak's at 110.
I feel like once Ryoku finally started finding conversions, like he started actually connecting, That's when Daybreak started to get a little flustered, and once he started mounting that damage and finally got that stock, like, he just ran with it. He took an inch and ran a mile. He really did. And that's just a sign of a good player.
Yeah, it was super good, because he was just he's been down for two straight games in a row. A really poor situation happened for him, but he held his composure. Now we're in game four. Ryoku tried to make this comeback, but Daybreak was still a one full game lead, so.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so this is game four.
Yeah.
Daybreak trying to close his set out. There's that nice tomahawk we've been talking about.
I'm surprised that it wasn't closed out last game, but like we said, Ryoku was playing out of his mind to make that comeback.
Yeah, it was very good. Against a player like Daybreak, it's no easy task.
Yup. And now Daybreak's going to probably just accept the fact that, wow, he didn't even accept the bullets. He just ran right through him.
That's some amazing movement to evade those.
Yeah. Oh, look at all that. Yeah, look at all.
He's feeling himself. He's got the movement going. He's got the limit on, and that's what you got to do is Cloud. You just got to threaten.
Daybreak even
make
looks
your presence
like
known.
He's in the zone, man.
Man, that was... Yeah, expecting a raw approach, didn't get it. Now he's going to find himself in a Wishwish combo for it, although instead of the afterburner kick, goes for a back air.
Okay, going to make it back. It's always so scary.
I know.
Ryoku, he knew he was coming back, but everybody else in this room, probably 50-50, they're like, yeah, it's Bayonetta.
I feel like he just wanted to go straight. He wanted to hit the stage, but didn't get it. Regardless, he's still okay.
Oh, just down smashed him.
That's it.
He just saw him overextend a little too much, and Ryoku looked like he was about to approach again, so he just threw the down smash, connects, gets the kill, but Ryoku, not going to find the stock, but some decent damage.
That's within the jab.
The jab one, yeah.
I don't mind that. He wanted Witch Time, which is fine, because it really allows you to get that good combo, guaranteed like 30-40%.
Mm-hmm.
And with a stock lead, that's exactly what you want. Or no, he doesn't have a stock
lead. No, he's down.
Yeah, he's down.
Okay, so yeah, he's going to have to use the limit here. Is that it? No, wow. Still a lot.
That's going to be it.
Oh, wait a second. There's a platform there. Oh, he doesn't have a jump. I'm down.
No, he had no jump.
I'm like, why? I thought he had a jump that whole time.
If he did, he would have probably made it, yeah.
Yeah.
But, hey, just good use of bullet arts to seal that stock. So not really just taking advantage of Cloud's poor disadvantage.
And I like what Ryoku's starting to do. He's starting to literally just stand there. And when a lot of times Ryoku started approaching, Daybreak would punish him. Holy crap.
It's a lot of damage.
But what happened is Daybreak would approach. So instead, Ryoku's like just standing there, and Daybreak just approached him for what reason? I don't know. But like, you know, he's playing so much more patient this game.
Yeah, that's kind of what Bayo does best, honestly. It's just wait for you to approach, wait for you to come in, and then she just hits you with something quick like that, whether it's Witch Twist or a down tilt, and it starts everything.
It's so good. But Daybreak now with full control of the stage. But once again, Ryoku just being super patient. And like, this is kind of how Ryoku plays too. So like, I'm not too surprised to see this, but I'm surprised we didn't see this earlier.
Yeah. Looks like Ryoku just winning the spacing battle and just kind of winning the footsies with Daybreak, and he's just mounting percent here, 99% already.
Sometimes there can be too much movement, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like Daybreak, once you start feeling yourself a little bit, sometimes the answer is literally just stand there, they'll throw something, you grab them. It's sometimes a very simple solution, but that Wish Time's not it. And Ryoku in a little bit of a disadvantage now, especially with this platform showing up.
Whatever.
That was a wacky hitbox.
Oh no! Yeah, that's like almost confirmed.
Yeah, with that platform there to land on, and the platform was going towards him. Yeah, that's tough.
Yeah, fair to forward smash is basically gonna work. The only chance you have is to DIOA and jump.
Yeah,
that's really all you can do.
And then being a Cloud that far off stage, man, you don't want to be DIOA wasting your jump either, too.
Yeah,
so
I mean,
it's like
you're kind of forced into a bad spot regardless. But at least it's not your stock.
Right. At least you have a chance of living.
Yeah. Then maybe you can up B or something. But regardless, he lost his stock that way. And you know, we were talking about how he might go Falco in a game five situation, but it's going to be the Cloud through and through, and I think that's the right choice.
When I said that earlier too, I thought there was no way we'd be seeing a game five how dominant Daybreak was, but Ryoku squeaking by on that third game.
Can't count Bayonetta out, man.
Yeah, squeaking by third game, fourth game, looking pretty dominant.
All right, here we go. This should be a combo.
Ooh.
Wow, I thought Witch Twist was going to come out a little sooner, but I think he wanted to extend that fair.
Can't blame him. It's been working for him very well.
All right, there it is, and wow, just Ryoku off to a crazy start here, 86% unanswered. Daybreak's got to keep his composure.
Yeah, Daybreak, you're noticing from Daybreak, too, is the lack of movement at this point.
Yeah.
Like, he's starting to just throw hitboxes, which is fine with Cloud a lot of the times because you can auto-cancel him, but that's where Ryoku's been punishing, man.
Yeah, he's just trying to get Ryoku in the air and start juggling, which is what Cloud does best, especially against Bayonetta, and that's where he just brought this game back to dead even, so very smart. Daybreak really utilizing those aerials, like falling aerials onto shield for safe shield pressure. And Ryoko really not able to do too much.
There's the jabs though, and now with this limit, like, Ryoko got to be very weird, but Daybreak at the same time. Ooh, I thought that was going to be a tomahawk grab, but okay.
Well, yeah, there it is.
Just run away, run back in, cross slash. That's a stock. Ryoko down to his winner stock, possibly.
Yeah, that's conditioning right there.
That really was.
Yep. Conditioning Ryoko to look for maybe a short hop.
Maybe a tomahawk grab,
Exactly.
I thought it.
Yeah. So Daybreak now, after this two. Oh, no. That's it. Ryoko keeping this dead even. One stock apiece. It all comes down to this.
Yeah, game five, man. You can't ask for a better set than this. And here we go. It's honestly whoever gets this startup, I think, is going to have such momentum. And it is Daybreak with an early 39%.
Yeah, good weight on the heel slide there, getting the basically guaranteed cross slash, which is a lot of percent. Oh, 57 already just from two of them. So Ryuko's got to be super careful on his approaches right now.
Daybreak starting to groove again as well. You can see him dashing back, dashing in, charging that limit a little bit, forcing Ryoko to possibly try to punish him. But here we go.
Yeah, he missed the upkick of the heel slide, so he wasn't able to get any kind of combo. Like, all he needs is one. He needs one combo right now to at least bring this back to even percents and possibly take Daybreak off the top. He does accumulate some rage. Oh, I want to get out of there.
Yeah,
get out of there.
Yeah.
Limit cross slash. No, jeez. No, that's unfortunate.
Even though Daybreak has a percent lead, this becomes a lot more difficult without limit.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's got it. He's got to just play patient and get this limit, I think.
Ryoko really not following up on these conversions. Like, he gets, like two or three hits that looks like he's going to start something, but then he just flat
like
out
that?
Misses. Daybreak was able to jump away.
Yeah.
All right, here he goes, though. He's got it. He's got him in the air. Oh, great SDI.
That almost looked like that really jank kind of witch twist, too, that brings you right where he wants you, but...
Yeah. Looks like he was able to fall off to the side.
Let's see. Oh, my goodness. 111% on Ryoko. It's starting...
Oh.
Wow, almost just straight gets the grab on the platform.
Tomahawk grabs, dude. He's so good at it.
He conditions you with tomahawk grabs, and all of a sudden he's cross-slashing in your face with the tomahawk instead.
There's one thing on his mind, and it's limit cross-slash. Daybreak.
Gonna find that, man.
I knew he was looking for it. I knew that's the one thing, only thing on his mind is, I want to use this limit cross-slash, and I'm going to get it.
Faked out a tomahawk, limit cross-slash. Because Ryoko's like,